The Google News Initiative is working with the news industry to help journalism fight hoax in digital era. And now, we're here with the chief of Google News Lab in Pacific Region, Ms. Irene Liu.
Hello.
Hello. I'm so glad that we have time to interview you. So you're going to fly back to Singapore tomorrow.
I am. So I'm based in Singapore, but of course, as part of my work with the News Lab, we're very focused on Indonesia and the election, as well as the elections elsewhere in the region too.
All right, so what do you think of our Indonesian presidential election?
Well, I have to say, it's obviously a really important time in the history of Indonesia. So many people going out to vote, more and more of the population going online for the first time. It's a really exciting moment for the country. I think also with more people online, there's a need for the news industry and for journalism to come together to work and make sure that voters have access to high quality information. And that's also in our interest at Google, so that's why we want to work with them.
How do you ensure the facts are confirmed?
We at Google, we actually are working with journalists to make sure that journalists have the tools they need to get information out there. We believe that in this very noisy era of the internet, it's much more powerful to make sure that those who have authoritative information, who have editorial standards when they're writing and publishing news, actually have a louder voice.
So what are the benefits of this collaboration?
So I think that there are a lot of benefits of the collaboration. The first thing is that when different news organizations come together and cooperate, it means that they can accomplish much more, right? Because so often when it comes to a news story, everyone will be fact-checking the same facts. They'll be trying to cover the same story. When it comes to a debate, when you have a very short amount of time, when news organizations are collaborating together and they're able to divide up the work, they can actually fact-check much more. And it's much more powerful, I think, in an increasingly polarized moment, when you have many different news organizations coming together to do the fact checks, it's a very powerful statement that journalists are working together and that they are very committed to making sure that the public has high quality information.
So what are the obstacles for this collaboration in Indonesia specifically?
I mean, of course, newsrooms are always historically competitive with each other. So I think that, I'm not the expert. I think you should talk to some of the founding members of Check Facta to get their sense of what the challenges are. But what I would say is generally, it is a very huge, it's an incredible achievement for so many news organizations, 24 news organizations and Mafindo to come together and cooperate. News Lab works with a lot of these collaborative efforts around the world, and they're always challenging, and you always have to work through overcoming that competitive nature. But when they do come together, it can be very powerful.
Our audience also very curious about yourself, like about you.
Okay.
I know that you are a journalist, so you are also the head of the Google News Lab. So can you please share a little bit experience to other people that want to be the journalist in Indonesia?
Sure. So, I feel really lucky. I was able to work as a reporter for 10 years, focusing on investigative and data journalism before I joined Google 2 years ago. And what I would say is that this is an incredibly important time for journalists. It's been a very challenging moment for the news industry, and I think a lot of journalists are wondering, how do you fit into this very noisy environment when anyone can take a photo or shoot a video or write an article. But I would say that, journalists need to come together. One thing that's been super encouraging is to see how everyone is starting to work together more.
And we hope that this collaboration could decrease the fake news all over the world. Thank you so much, Irene.
Thank you so much.